Finished another run. Having, you know, my energy goo gel, you know, with caffeine, kind of helps me kick in the, you know, focus. In this video, I want to share with you a serious money-making idea. Okay, this is not a joke. This is not to grab your attention, just get views. This is a serious one. So if you are serious about money or success or whatever, you know, this feel good bullshit words, watch this video. And yeah, Google's algorithm, like, share, comment, subscribe, ring the bell, all that fuck all shit, do all that crap. Okay, if you want to donate, don't forget. Okay, so what is the idea? I'll give my example. So instead of giving you theory, I'll give my example. Now, you know, how I earn is people will, you know, watch my videos, they find value, they watch it over the period of time, and then after a few months they realize, okay, I can trust this guy. And then if they feel they need my service, they either take my service or they refer somebody to me. So my business has never worked with ads. It has only worked on recommendations based on trust. Okay, now the challenge of this kind of sales and marketing approach is there's no guarantee for success. There is no guarantee for success in the sense there's no guarantee that I will get a customer each and every day. Now the question is, how do I make money? You know, every day I wake up, the first question that comes to my mind is, okay, how do I make money? And, you know, if you're an employee, if you are a guy who gets a salary, you don't have to think about how will I make money every day. You, by default, you'll get money because you have to go to the office, do the work, and end of the month, you get the salary. But this is a very dangerous way of thinking because you don't train your mind to think, how will I make money? If your mind is constantly focused, how will I make money? How will I make money? How will I make money? You know, your mind will constantly search for a solution. Okay, how will I make money? What should I do? Who should I target? How much should I charge? What value should I offer the person? How to close the customer? So your brain goes into an overdrive where it always seeks to, provide value so that you can get money. And unfortunately, this is also a way how scammers and fraudsters also work. They don't provide any value, but they want to make money. So they're looking for ways to cheat people. So that is why scammers, hackers, all these fraudsters, no matter how smart the system is, no matter how tough they make it, they'll always find a loophole. I mean, the human mind is capable of finding a solution. So no matter, like, even for my baby, no matter what I do, if I remove all the chairs, she will go get pillows to climb up. I remove all the pillows, she will try to climb using a support. If I remove that, she will, you know, she always tries to find a way. You know, we human beings like to find a solution. So now The first thing for you, the first secret is you need to get out of this employee mindset. And by that, I mean, get out of your fucking comfort zone, man. Just get the fuck out of your comfort zone. You will not believe the number of people who have contacted me this year. I've lost my job. I worked 20 years with the company. I worked 30 years with the company, I worked 15 years with the company, law I worked day and night, law I gave them my blood, sweat, tears. And now they have terminated me, they have not given my gratuity, they have not, you know, they have not supported me. Now these people all are good at what they do, they are very good. It's not that they are bad. They're very good engineers, they're very good accountants, they're very good administrators. Some people work multiple jobs, some people work 6 days a week, some even work 7 days a week. So they are very dedicated, they're very hardworking, they're very smart at their jobs. But they're very bad at selling themselves, they're very bad at proactively thinking, how can I market myself, how can I add value? So the first one, and the core problem for this is they are in their comfort zone. They assumed, like a marriage that is supposed to last forever, they don't want to reinvent themselves. Like, for example, look at a marriage. If the husband is rich and the wife is beautiful and she believes the husband will love her no matter what, she will just relax, she will eat as much as she wants, she will not take care of herself. Eventually, she puts on all the, packs on all the pounds and she becomes fat. See, when the female is single, she works hard to look beautiful, attractive, so she can attract a mate. Once after she gets married, oh, I have him, he loves me, okay, I'll eat as much, and become fat like a buffalo. And then they wonder why their husband doesn't love them. Same thing with men. Some men, they get so complacent in their workplace. Initially, when they start, they have the fire, they dress up smart, they look smart, they wear a suit, they clean shave, they look dynamic, they keep themselves fit, they are young, full of energy. As years go by, they come, you know, hardly dressed up, they're saying, just wearing clothes, looking fat, looking globish. You know, the comfort zone will fucking kill you, man. So the first thing is, get the fuck out of your comfort zone. Just get out of it. Okay? And how do you get out? Just ask yourself this critical question. If I knew for a fact, guaranteed, that I would lose my job next month, guaranteed, I will lose my job next month. Or if you're a businessman, okay, there's going to be a lockdown. They're going to ask me to shut down my business for 3 months or 6 months. What will I do now for the next 30 days? What will I do? Now, if you're an employee and you know, fuck, I'm going to lose my job, you will immediately contact somebody. Hey, listen, man, do you have contacts, connections? You'll contact your friends. Hey, if you know any vacancy, help me out. Let me know. You will check, you know, if you're smarter, you'll even go to a professional guy and check your CV. Is my CV proper? Okay. Is my interview skills good? Can you take a test? Okay. Can you evaluate me and find out whether I'm fit enough for the job market? So you'll proactively think 10 steps ahead. So that, and then you'll even check, okay, how do I get my gratuity? Okay, who's asked to have to kiss in the company to protect my self-interest? Okay, what about my visa? How much money is in the bank? What all my cards, loans? What do I not need in the house? You will think like a fucking, I don't know, like a machine. When you know that, fuck, I'm going to lose my job. And that is the mindset of people who get in touch with me, who know that, fuck, I'm going to lose my job. I don't want to be in the streets. Okay? And as a businessman, when you know that, fuck, 6 months, nothing is going to happen, you would work overdrive to collect every bit of penny. Every bit of revenue you can from people. If you have to speak to a customer, you know, before, if you know guaranteed you will get an income, they'll say, this is my rate, take it or leave it. But if you know that, fuck, I'm not going to get a customer for next 2-3 months, you'll be like, okay, what is your budget? Tell me. Okay, how can I close the sale? What can we do? You tell me how we can make it happen. Fine, this is the rate, let's make it happen. And you'll work with a sense of desperation. And that is how you'll grow. You know, and that's how you grow, man. Otherwise, you cannot survive. So, like I was telling you, my own personal example, no? When I knew that, fuck, okay, the COVID is going to have a complete lockdown. People are going to, you know, lose their jobs. Nobody will want to spend. Nobody will want to take up personal branding. Because, see, when people are going to lose their jobs, or when they are going to be unemployed, or there's lack of security, nobody wants to invest $10,000, $25,000, $50,000 on their personal brand. You know, okay, the rich guy might spend $100,000. Okay, Lloyd, my personal brand, this big package, this company. But the small time guys, they're not going to think $10,000 and all that. So I had to immediately go on an emergency mode where I said, okay, what is required now? What does the market want now? Okay, they will want CVs, they will want jobs. Immediately from the month of January this year, I had switched my focus into job searches, got in touch with recruiters, got in touch with my old contacts in big positions, brushed up my skills for resume rebranding, asked successful people their CVs, those who really knew how to market themselves. I completely reinvented myself from January because I knew this COVID virus, this thing, lockdown, is going to impact the whole world. I had to look 6 months ahead. And that's how I made money this year. My strategy for last year was different. My strategy for this year is different. Now, 2021 is going to be again different. It can't be the same. Same thing with you. If your strategy is still the same what it was 2016, 2018 you will be unemployed. If 2018 it was the same, 2020 you lose your job. What happened? Why so many cabin crew lost their jobs? Why so many administrators, receptionists, engineers, why they lost their job? They were comfortable. They knew, oh, I have a job. Nothing will happen to me. Don't need to worry. And then when you lose your job, you can't blame anyone but yourself, man. You can't blame anyone. You know, I know this might sound like it is a rant. You know, Filipinos, I've never had a Filipino client. I mean, in my 20 years, I think three Filipinos. Okay. Now, Filipinos, very smart, very creative. I love the Filipino culture, sharing. But yes, there are a couple of drawbacks that they have. For example, they are very clannish. They are very, they pull themselves down. Sometimes they, you know, like they call this a crab mentality, which even the Indians have. Now, the one thing about Filipinos, no? They'll spend a lot of money for style. They will spend a lot of money for parties. They will spend a lot of money to show off. They'll spend money for, fashion, for sports, for training. They'll spend a lot of money for all this, okay? But where it comes to their education and training, seriously, I have yet to...
Hello.
Hey, Saga. I've yet to meet a Filipino who has invested in his personal brand, who stands out. Most of them, like, you know, this is not a hate on them. Most of them, even if they enjoyed a big salary and they have lost their job, they will ask you for help and all that, but they'll not spend on their, this thing. They'll, how much? They'll not even want to know, like, what do you get? How much? It's the same thing with our Indians have a very different, see, being Indian, I'm telling you this. Our Indians have a slightly different style. They'll want last price, discount. How much discount? What is your last price? Or the majority, no money. My mother, my father, no money. That's how it is, you know. This is not me trying to bash on them. Okay, just ask yourself, how many Filipino CEOs are there globally? Filipino CEOs, how many? And Indians, we have a population of 1 billion. Out of 1 billion, how many we have? You can count. Satya Nadella, Indira Nooyi, Ajay Banga. Who else? That means, what, a handful, 10? 10 out of 1 billion? Look at the odds, man. So, you know, the problem is, if you do not know how to sell and market yourself, if you do not know how to brand yourself professionally, you can't survive. And this is not me just selling you my services. Yes, I am selling what I do to people. Yes, this is without a doubt. The purpose of the video, the everything, is to sell. But, end of the day, if I cannot sell myself, how can I survive? You who's watching the video, you seriously think that I'm not aware that you're smarter than me, that you can't Google search, you can't check YouTube videos, you can't find answers. Man, I wouldn't survive if I underestimated people. I can't survive. See, here's my question to you. How have I survived all these years? By fooling people? Okay. If I've fooled people, where are the... Try cheating someone and running away. I can assure you, they will make sure you're exposed on social media. They will write blogs. They will share it on Facebook. They will share screenshots. Why in this 20 years of my life, nobody has shared a single evidence? Because the simple reason being is, I've always believed that you who's watching is smarter than me. And that is where I need to up my game. And this is the lesson for you. You need to understand the people you're dealing with are smarter than you, are sharper than you, are more intelligent than you. And you cannot fool them. That is why when someone sends me his CV, oh, Loy, can you have a look at my CV? I look at it. Okay, what about? No, is this good? Are you getting job offers? No, Loy, I'm not getting any job offers. Yeah, then your resume sucks. Oh, Loy, is my communication skills good? Every person you meet, do they offer you an appointment or interview? Yeah, Loy, they meet me, but nothing happens after that. That means your communication sucks. If you cannot close a sale, if you cannot convince a person to pay you fucking money, means you suck at selling. You don't know how to brand yourself. You don't know how to market yourself. You don't know how to sell yourself. See, the proof is in the pudding. It's like asking, is my dish, I cooked a chocolate cake, is it delicious? The proof is how many people are paying money to buy this. If nobody's paying any money to buy it, means it fucking sucks. See, you can sell, you can convince, this is the most delicious cake in the world, man. Trust me, you will die with pleasure if you eat it. People might, oh wow, okay, they buy it. But then you need to deliver. Okay, you sold it, but then you need to deliver. If it tastes ordinary or it tastes shit, the guy will eat the cake and think to himself, this guy is so full of shit, man. For me, yes, I can say I'm the world's number one personal branding strategist. But if I don't deliver, I don't meet up to it, the person who has taken my service will be, the guy's full of shit. So same thing with you. The first thing you need to know is how to fucking sell yourself. So first, get out of your fucking comfort zone. That's the first fucking thing. Second thing is use a sense of fucking urgency. Think, use your, you know, have that mindset, shit, there might be no tomorrow. I need to really think what the fuck to do. So there you work on overdrive for solutions, for learning how to market yourself, sell yourself, provide more value. You get that fire, you know, that hunger, that shit. You will not be able to sleep. You'll wake up in the morning, fuck, what do I do? That fire will burn under your ass. You will not even want to, you must have heard me say this hundreds of times. I don't even have time to play a game. Why? Because I'm fucking afraid. I don't know whether I'll be able to earn money or not. You know, it's very easy for someone, hey, what the fuck is talking, and comment and all. Those people are a bunch of losers. If you really are a creator, you'll not have time to look at other people, talk about other people, bitch about other people. Oh, him, he is a fucking chuto, she's a slut, or, hey, this fucking guy is a loser. No, you'll think, okay, your energy, your mind, your focus, because the brain can only think one thing at a time. You'll think, how can I sell myself? How can I market myself? How can I make more money? What do I have to do? You look at your bank balance every month and, you know, whatever money you earn, room it out, dump it in a savings account, again look at zero. Shit, it's zero. What do I do? And that's how you'll work, man. That's how you survive. Others, you cannot. You cannot. And I'll tell you, the people who work with me now, see, I give the example of Filipinos. It's not me hating on them. They are more creative than we Indians. They are more smarter. But the reason they are not getting paid big money, they don't know how to sell themselves. They don't know how to position themselves. That's why even though they are more creative, see, being Indian, I'm telling you this, they are more creative than most of the Indians. Very artistic. They get paid so much more less than Indians. Because at least Indians know how to bullshit their way. You meet an Indian in Mumbai, fuck, he'll sell you secondhand, he'll sell you your own underwear to you. But the thing is, not just selling, then you need to match up with your skills. You need to work so fucking hard. You need to practice, man. Every day you see me put up a fucking video. Every day you see me edit. Every day you see me answer messages. Every day you see me answer emails, WhatsApp. I'm trying to improve on the skills and not just do it as a repetitive task. I'm constantly asking myself, okay, how can I answer this in a way that will generate more income? Like, have you seen my YouTube community posts? I'm always redesigning it, changing, putting some... That is creativity at work. You know, people are saying, what the fuck is this breaking news? What the fuck is breaking? Well, that is creativity. Now, you'll not see breaking news. You'll see something else. Because I'm trying to improve. I've taken your criticism. Okay, fine. It's not breaking news. What do I put? How do I rebrand myself? See, man. Listen, I'll tell you, bottom line is this. If you're not making fuckloads of money, you're fooling yourself. I spoke to this one young boy from the UK. He was giving me a big lecture. Oh, you know, money is not everything, man. You know, satisfaction, you need to follow your passion. And he was trying to tell me he's some great, special fuckhole. This, who the fuck are you fooling, man? You know, money, who the fuck cares? Why do we remember Elon Musk? Why? He's special, yes, and he has made fuckloads of money. Jeff Bezos, special, fuckloads of money. Jack Ma, Warren Buffett, Mark Zuckerberg, Larry Ellison. Who remembers Mahatma Gandhi? Who remembers? Like any Mother Teresa charitable, who remembers? Nobody fucking cares. You want to live in that world, then go mix around with those kind of people. You want to live in the business world, the corporate world, the money-making world, you need to make fuckloads of money. I don't know about you, but I want to make money. I seriously want to make money. I want to live a good life, man. I don't fucking care about this. Help the poor, change the world, make it a better place. Michael Jackson and this and that and climate change and, oh, save animals. Sorry, I don't have the luxury to focus on all this bullshit. I need to take care of me, my family, my loved ones, and have a good life. That's me. If this doesn't resonate with you, you need to check out maybe charityashram.com or some, you know, selfless giving, helpthepoor.com. Not my channel. So the bottom line word, I've been using this word too often, bottom line. Okay, let me rephrase by saying, okay, the crux of the message, new word. The moral of the story. I just want to tell you this. Number one, get off your comfort zone. Number two, ask a different set of questions. Change your mindset. Ask yourself, if there is no tomorrow, if there is next month you lose your job, 3 months there's not going to be any business, what are you going to do? Work on overdrive. Focus on learning how to sell yourself, market yourself, brand yourself, position yourself. Then, focus on delivering the value that you promised. Go all out. Make them so impressed with you, they should say, sheesh man, this guy is amazing. And then they'll refer other people to you. And last but not the least, be very clear, what do you want? For me, it's money. For me, it's a good life. That's why I don't give a fuck about, you have to accept God into your life and this and that. Yes. Health is important. Yes, being with family is important. Yes, mental peace, and that comes by default. But if the main thing, that is money, it's not sorted out, you're going to be in deep trouble. And next year, 2021, I'm telling you, be fucking afraid. Be really fucking afraid, because it's not going to be good. At least that's my prediction. Anyway, this is what I wanted to share with you guys. Let me know what you think. Do you agree, disagree? You know, I love to read your thoughts, read your comments. And do support the channel if you can. Google the algorithm. If you like the content, please do like, share, subscribe, comment, you know. Anyway, if you can support the channel any other way, I'd appreciate. Thank you always for being part of the community. Right, you guys take care.
Thanks, you.
I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by a fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.